So you want to have a successful Pokemon Go Fest 2022? Well, today I'm going to teach you exactly my strategy on how to do so. So grab yourself some sparkling water, let's get straight to the video.
Just do it!
Alright, so here's the thing. I have a pretty good understanding after playing a bunch of Pokemon Go Fest, Pokemon Go Tours, all of that good stuff. You know, it's really cool to get like a bunch of shinies, you know, 40 shinies. What I found is a lot of times people always compare the amount of shinies that they got. But the thing is, it doesn't really matter like how many shinies you get. It's about the quality and what you need for your account. Because it's really nice to have like, you know, 40 shiny Bulbasaurs. But you really need that many, you know, it's better to have maybe 10 shinies throughout the day, but have like some quality shinies that you actually need in your game. So a very underrated aspect of Pokemon Go when it comes to Pokemon Go Tours, Go Fest, and all of that good stuff is something called organization. Now, I do see a lot of Pokemon YouTubers, you know, talk about, okay, so you need to prep, you know, your Pokeballs, your Ultra Balls, your Pokemon Go storage, obviously play in a busy place with a lot of spawns, you know, that's all true. And you should definitely do all that, that's true. But the one thing they don't really talk about is how to like plan your day, plan exactly what you're gonna do during the day, during each spawn hours and, you know, et cetera, et cetera. So I will show you exactly how I do that because I think that's like very, very underrated. And I think that alone just kind of like helps a ton and really can make the difference between having a good experience and a bad experience. Number one thing to do is have fun, but it is more fun when you accomplish your goals and, you know, what you actually wanna get in the game, or at least most of it. So here's what we're gonna do. So first things first, you wanna go to a browser, you know, and look at exactly what's gonna be spawning in the event. So this event is gonna happen on, you know, Saturday, August 27th at 10 a.m. local time, all the way to 6 p.m. local time. Here you go. So the first thing you wanna do is you wanna open up a notepad, you know, or like, you know, on your phone, just go ahead. So here's what I'm gonna do. And what you wanna do is you wanna break down every habitat basically on your notepad. You know, I already prepped this, and then you write down all the habitats. So I have right here, so whole events. So that's for Pokemon that's gonna be spawning throughout the whole event. You're gonna have the Feramosa, you know, that's for this one right here, Buzzwole, the Zuckatree, and the Nihiligo. You're gonna basically look at this and you're gonna see and think, okay, what do I need for my account? So looking through this, now the first thing I can see obviously is the new Shaman Scarf Pikachu. You know, that's a new custom Pikachu. Personally, I kinda care about it, you know, I kinda want it in my account. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna write down right here in the whole event, because as you can see, it will be spawning throughout the event. And at the same time, I kinda want the shiny version of it. So what I'm gonna do is do another bullet point, a custom Pikachu. So now I know that throughout the event, you know, that is something that I will, you know, target. All right, so next up, let's go ahead and actually look at, you know, for almost an hour. So what exactly do I need for my accounts? You know, I don't need any shinies from this habitat. I kind of have everything already. The one thing I do care and I kind of want to do is I want to grind for Scyther XL candies. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to write down right here in the Formosa hour, Scyther XL candies, and I will do that for my Mega Scizor. So I do need 296 XL candies in order to max one out. So I will put in parentheses 296. Boom, so I know that I will need that amount of XL candies. That's basically what I'm gonna be doing during this 2 hours. It's just farm Scyther XL candies. Let's see if I need anything else. I think maybe pincers, so I will do this too, because there is a mega pincer that's gonna come out in the game a little soon. If you want, you know, like let's say him on top, it's a rare shiny, you need it. Write down shiny him on top. That's something you're gonna be focusing on, you know, during those 2 hours, trying to get that. Personally, I don't need any of this, so I'm just gonna move on to the next hour. So here we have the Buzzwole hours from 12 to 2. Now, personally, aside from the Pikachu, obviously, I don't need anything from here. Yeah, I don't care about the Axew either, but you write down again, you write down anything that you need out of here. If you're a shiny hunter and you need one more Axew or two more Axews or three more Axews, you know, write down Axew times 3, Magmar XLs, you know, whatever you need. Just write down whatever you need in the Balls Wild. Personally, I don't need anything, so I'm just gonna skip through it right here. Zuckatree, 2 to 4. So again, what do you need in this habitat? Personally, again, I don't really need anything here, except for the Electabuzz XL candies, because I am trying to max out my Shadow Electivires. Electabuzz XL, and for Shadow one, I do need 360 of them. All right, next up is the next hour, 4 to 6. So that's in Nihiligo. Again, write down what you need. Personally, looking through this, I do need the Muna, that is a new shiny. And I will write down Muna. And I do want, you know, two of them because I do need the evolution for it. Musharna, pretty sure that's how you spell, I'm not sure. Something else I do need is the Swirlix. Swirlix. I also need the evolution for the whole family, so I'm gonna write down Slurpuff. So next up, let's keep going down, because there is some stuff. So there is the incense. We got all those unknown letters spawning throughout the event. So personally, I do need a few of them. So I'm gonna go back to the whole event tab right here. And whatever you need, write it down. So that's all for the unknown, that's all that you need. Now let's keep going down. Now there is like the incense only for a specific hour. So we have, you know, Mr. Mime, Pensage. If you need any of those, again, write it down. I guess for Pensage or Mr. Mime, let's say you need those. You would go back into the Formosa, Boswell, Xocatree, whatever hour you need, and just put that inside the specific slot. So for raids, again, those are gonna be happening throughout the day for all of those. I suggest, you know, whatever you need, put in the whole event category. You know, for example, not all people are gonna look for Axew. So every time you see a little raid, do it, you know, etc., etc. Then there's also the five-star raids. Now, five-star raids, every 2 hours, you will have, you know, the specific Pokemon popping up during its respected hour. I do need a couple of Formosa, at least, because I don't have one. So I will go back here in the Formosa hour, and I will go ahead and quickly add Formosa. Boswell, I do have one. I do want more. The Xocatree, I do need Xocatree. I don't have one. And Heligo, I'm good with Heligo. I don't really need care about farming those. So there you go. Now, as you can see, everything is kind of organized. I have what I'm gonna be hunting throughout the event. So looking through this, you can kind of like organize your day. So again, Boswell hour, aside from doing Boswell raids, I'm really, and shiny checking unknowns, I really don't have else to do. So I guess it would be kind of like a good time to take a break, I guess. You know, if I want to eat something, you know, do something else, I can, because breaks are kind of like underrated during those days. And or, you know, I could also advance my special research during that time, you know, advance the special research as much as I can. I'm pretty sure it's gonna be a collection challenge as well, so make sure you do the collection challenge every habitat. That's definitely something that you want to keep in mind. You just go on, you catch whatever you have. So here's what's gonna happen, right? Let's say you need a shiny Anorith, okay? You need a shiny Anorith. That's kind of like what you need during that time. So instead of focusing on shiny clicking on Woobats, you know, that you might already have, or you know, Pinsir, you know, are all the stuff that you don't need. Instead of focusing on that, just don't even bother clicking on it. Just go ahead and just shiny check Anorith, and that's it. Just focus on Anorith. Walk around the park, you don't see Anorith, keep walking. Try and find Anorith. Really focus and pinpoint down exactly that you need that one. If you need more, if you need, like, for example, you're gonna, like, new to the game, you're gonna need everything, then just shiny check everything. And then whatever you get, you're gonna be happy either way, because, you know, you didn't get any. And then as soon as you complete, you know, one of your goals, and then all you do is boom, put a little check mark next to it. You've completed this. Now you can move on. You can focus on something else. And then just keep repeating that. And then at the end of the day, you will see exactly why you did complete, why you didn't, because yes, there is a good probability that you're not gonna get everything that you want. At the end of the day, at least you're gonna look back at your notes and you're gonna be like, whoa, you know what? I had a pretty successful day. I completed over 50% of the things that I wanted, 60%. And you might end up way more happy than, you know, just playing the game completely blind, you know, shiny checking a little bit of everything, and then end up the game with, oh, I just got a shiny, I don't know, 2 shiny cricket tuts, and that's it. You know what I mean? So I think that's like the best way to do it. That's the way that I've been doing, and to be honest, kind of been paying off. All right, guys, so if you guys enjoyed this video and this kind of like helped you guys a little bit, you know, organize, you know, what you're gonna do exactly, make sure you drop a like. And if you want to see more content like this, make sure I subscribe. I will be doing a lot more Pokemon Go content. I will also keep doing my regular Pokemon content, so y'all let me know exactly what you want to see. I'll catch you guys next time. Peace.